What's going on out here? Is it Fan Friday? Say, it's Fan Friday!
We're going to the snow dogs!
I'm Carrie and this is Kit and it's Fan Friday!
Well, what's going on over here, Dirty Face? What are we trying to hide in the dirt over here? Memphis is gonna find it. Look, Oakley's buried another apple. Brew the Husky from Instagram wants to know if Shelby likes to dig. Yes, no, actually that wasn't the question. The question was, what style of harness do you suggest for bike touring / scootering? We actually use the Urban Mushing Harness. Phone's going off. We actually use the Urban Mushing Harness for those activities. I use my crossback harness for sledding, but when it comes to scootering and bike touring, I actually like the Urban Mushing Harness better, and you can get those at alpineoutfitters.net. Quite a few of you had questions this week about training your dogs and them not listening. A couple of you asked about husky puppies, a couple of you asked about different breeds of dogs, but they were all pretty much the same question about what can I do when my dog is not listening when training. There's a lot of different ways to train dogs. There's many different training methods, many different training styles. Everybody does it differently, and not every training method will work for every dog, and not every person is going to be able to do every training method effectively. That being said, when you have a dog that isn't listening when you're trying to train them, part of the reason may be because they have too much energy, especially when it comes to huskies. Huskies are a very high energy dog. And if they haven't had a lot of exercise yet and you're trying to work on training, their brains are still going, I want to do this, I want to do this, I want to do this. So sometimes, before you actually start training your dog, go play with your dog. Shelby, you have a leaf hanging on your tail. All right, we got the leaf off her tail. So anyway, sometimes it's a good idea to actually take the dog and go for a walk, go for a run, take them outside, throw the ball back and forth for a little bit, play with them and kind of wear their brains out a little bit. That actually will help when it comes to training, because instead of them being focused on everything else, they'll be a little bit more tired and they'll be actually be able to focus on you and what you're doing a little bit better. So that would be one thing I would try. Another thing, I don't know if you're trying to train with food. I've always had really good experience training with food. My dogs are very food responsive, and I've always had it a little bit easier personally for me with training when I use food. Some people use clickers, some people use a toy. I have a friend of mine who has a lab, and his lab's reward for everything is his ball. Like, the dog does something they want him to do, and they give him the ball. The cat's not back here anymore, babe. So there are a lot of different training styles, a lot of different ways to train, but for getting them to focus, see, like, they're not focusing on me at all right now. For getting them to focus, you definitely may want to take them out, exercise them, like I said, run around, play in the yard, just really wear them out, and then work on training. And you don't have to train for long. Another thing about training should be fun. When your dogs are learning new things, learning new tricks, learning how to do things, it should be fun. You really don't want to sit down and train, like if trying to train a dog, sit. You don't want to sit there and be doing it for half an hour, same command over and over and over. Do it for like 5 minutes, maybe 10 minutes. You'll be able to tell when you have such a dirty face. You'll be able to tell when your dog is getting bored, and when they get bored, that's it. Don't push them. Wait a couple hours and work on it again. Personally, in my own experience, I have found that if you constantly try to train the same thing or train for long periods of time, dogs get bored and it doesn't become fun. And if it's not fun, like anything else, they're not going to want to do it. So you want to make it a fun, positive experience for the dog. A good example of this is like when we do agility. We really only train each agility obstacle for about 10 to 15 minutes. And that's it, when they're first learning. You know, we put them on the A-frame. We literally have them touch the A-frame, touch the A-frame, touch the A-frame. But we only do it for a little bit because touching the A-frame over and over gets boring to them. Once they've conquered it, they've conquered it. So what's the big deal? So you do it for a little while and then you move on to something else. And like I said, this is basically gonna be a training video, isn't it? if you're having a really hard time with training, I really do highly suggest going to a puppy class or finding a group class where you can learn how to train your dog. It helped me immensely when I did those things with my dogs, and it's something that I would suggest to anybody who has a dog that is having a hard time with training. Or I did training classes with, we had Shiloh, and I did training classes with Shelby, even though I had already trained Shiloh, because I just wanted that refresher on how to train a dog. So I hope that helps. If you guys have any other suggestions on training, how to keep your dog focused while training, anything to help all these people that are trying to train their dogs, leave some comments down in the video description below. Start some conversation down there, you guys. You are more than welcome to talk to each other down there and answer some of these questions if you guys have an answer that you think might work better than what I say. And another thing is, down in the video description, there's going to be a link to our new Facebook group. There's actually been a lot of conversation going on there, which is really awesome. A lot of really cool audience members are in there, bouncing questions off each other, getting answers from other people. It's been really nice. So if you guys want to join our Facebook group, there will be a link down in the video description for that also. Curly Millers wants to know, what do you do if you lose your dog's ID tag? I think Memphis found the hole back there. If our dogs lose their tags, they actually are microchipped. So if they lose their tags and they manage to get out, thankfully they have a microchip, which is something I would suggest to anybody with a dog. But if I lose their tags, we just buy more tags. We got some mail. We got some mail. Memphis, it almost looks like you have extra ears. Oh, and maybe extra eyes. Oakley's over there on the couch. We got a letter from Trinity, and Trinity had a couple questions. One of them was, do you have any tips for sled training? I saw you said you already bought the mush book. That would be definitely the first place to start. I hope this winter to actually do a more in-depth video on training sled dogs. Another question was, do you have to feed your dogs in separate rooms? Nope, they all eat right here together. That's Memphis's bowl, that's Shelby's bowl, and there's Oakley's bowl. And they actually all eat right in here together. Do you still have socks for sale? The limited edition Oakley socks and Shelby socks are already gone. We are going to be doing Memphis socks and Shiloh socks, and then if you guys want, we'll do another run with a different picture of the other girls again, and we'll just donate to another charity. I like doing those because it helps raise money for charity. So currently we don't have any for sale, but I think Memphis will be next. And we got a letter and a drawing from Caesar with a couple questions. One of the questions was, do huskies get along with other dogs? Like any dog, any personality, they all have different personalities. Some of them do, some of them don't. How often do they shed? All of the time. They shed more when they're blowing coat, but they actually shed all the time. Is it true that huskies dig a lot in the backyard? Yeah, if you watched earlier in the video, you can see where and how they like to do that. You can train them to dig like in one area, but actually stopping them from digging, good luck with that. And we got a belated happy birthday card for Shelby from Cece. And we got another happy belated happy birthday for Shelby. And this one is from Donnie, Dusty, and Cecilia. I think I got them all. What? Are you kicking her butt? Are you kicking her butt? She's kicking your butt, Shelby. What's the deal? She's totally kicking your butt. You're just letting her win today, aren't you? She's gonna get ya. Hi, babe. And we got a box from Lee, Jamie, Aiden, Snickers, and Flash. And this box is not for you guys. This is actually for Snow Dogs Vlogs, which means it's for your daddy and I. And look what it is! Ta-da! Oreo cookies! Thanks, you guys, for sending those. That's pretty cool. I think we're going to take some down to Ohio with us to share them with our friends! Oreos are my favorite cookies, if you guys don't know. Most of you guys know by now. And then we got a box from Jeannie, Alyssa, Aries, and Athena. Some of this stuff is for you guys, but some of this stuff is for your daddy and I. Check this out. For those of you that don't know, if you watch our vlogs, you already know. Nightmare Before Christmas is my absolute favorite movie of all time. Check that out. Now I've got to find a place to put them. There's so much stuff in here. There's dog treats and Oreo sticks and a Memphis head and a Nightmare Before Christmas cup and more Oreo stuff. You guys are awesome. There's pumpkin spice Oreos down there. Check that out. Pumpkin spice Oreos. Sorry, girls, you can't have the Oreos, but I'll give you a treat in a little bit, okay? You just ate, so you gotta wait a little bit. Thanks for sending that stuff, you guys. It's awesome. Might have to open some of that up in a vlog. All right, you guys, that's all we have for Fan Friday today. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. I know it's kind of a short one on questions, but we did a really long answer to the training question. Somebody asked about when our next meetup will be. Another reason this video is short is we are having a YouTube gathering at Cedar Point in Ohio tomorrow, Saturday, October 3rd. We're actually meeting outside of the gates at about 9 o'clock in the morning so we can meet up with some of our YouTube friends, and then we're all going to go enjoy the park together. It's a YouTube gathering. It's pretty much a creators gathering, but if you guys are in Ohio and you're in the area, we'll be there. The dogs will not, of course, because they don't let dogs ride roller coasters. I'm not really sure why, because I'm sure that Memphis would ride one. She's back there still thinking that the chipmunk is going to come back, but it's not. It's not going to come back, honey. You scared it away, I promise. Other than that, our next meetup will be at the Pet Expo in Novi, and at least Memphis will be with us there. And I believe the date for that, it's a Saturday. I think it's November 21st in Novi, Michigan at the Pet Expo. And it sounds like we're going to have a booth inside. Oh, really, the chipmunk is not there, girls. I'm telling you. So, all right, you guys, if you have not done so yet, you should check out our vlog channel, which is youtube.com/snowdogsvlogs. We will be uploading footage from our YouTube gathering that we're going to this weekend sometime next week over on that channel. And, of course, as always, any pretty much behind-the-scenes stuff of things that go on in our lives with the dogs go up on that channel. So you should definitely go over there and check it out. Subscribe if you haven't. And I think that's it. I feel like I'm catching a cold, so I think I'm going to go lay down and take a nap since we're taking a trip tomorrow. All right, you guys, thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. Stay positive, dream big, and we'll see you soon. Goodbye. Shelby, can you say goodbye? Can you say goodbye? How about you, dirty face Oakley? Look, Memphis, you have a dirty face too. Show him. Memphis, come here. Look at that dirty face. Look, well, you don't have to come that close. You both got dirty faces. Turn around and roll over, snow, 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 snow,